Yeah, dear students, welcome back to the problem of estimating cash flows after taxes. Just let me continue from the fourth row. So I hope students can see this PDF file, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's great. So we just now we found earnings before depreciation, interest, and tax by deducting incremental cost from the incremental revenue of the project. So 120 minus 80 is equal to 40 million rupee each year is the earnings before depreciation, interest, and taxes. Okay, so I think 1, 2, 3, these rows are not that difficult to understand. Okay, now what are we going to do? See, if you can understand this concept. Okay, see, you know, names, for example, names in India have meaning, right? Anand means happy, correct? So Asha means hope. Okay, so not all the English names have meaning, huh? Remember this, most of the English names do not have meaning, but Indian names have meaning. Same way, if you can understand these concepts in financial management or corporate finance, half of your problem will be solved. What it says, pay attention, earnings, I'll stress on B, before. Okay, I'll stress on B, that is before earnings, before depreciation, interest, and tax. What you have to do? Simply deduct depreciation, interest, and tax. That's it, to arrive at earnings after EAT, earnings after taxes. That is what you need to find out. Okay, then to that earnings after taxes, you need to add back depreciation. That's it. So now we are going to deduct depreciation. Okay, please remember, depreciation you need not calculate in this problem. It is readily available in the problem. Okay, so these depreciation amounts we are going to put in for each year. So depreciation for year 1 is 20 million rupees, year 2 15 million rupees, year 3 11.25 million rupees, year 4 8.44 million rupees, year 5 6.33 million rupees. So after deducting depreciation, what remains is earnings before interest and taxes. So remove interest, okay, deduct interest. The difference, 40 minus 20 is equal to 20 million rupees, 40 minus 15 is equal to 25 million rupees. So 40 minus 11.25 is equal to 28.75 million rupees. 40 minus 8.44 is equal to 31.56 million rupees. 40 minus 6.33 is equal to 33.67 million rupees is earnings before interest and taxes for of the each year. Then simply deduct interest on debt. So remember, the company has borrowed. Okay, the company has borrowed 50 million rupees of debt capital. Okay, and the debt capital carries the interest rate of 15%. So 15% of 50 million rupees you need to calculate and deduct it from each year. So here, less interest, 15% less interest on debt. Amount of debt is 50 million rupees the company has borrowed from bank, and the rate of interest is 15%. So you need to pay interest every year. So 15% of 50 million rupees is 7.5 million rupees each year the company has to pay interest on debt or interest on loan. So deduct that. Okay, so 20 minus 7.5 is equal to 12.5. What you get is earnings before taxes. Okay, okay. See, now students pay attention. Like how depreciation is deducted from taxable income, same way interest paid on debt is also deducted from taxable income. It is not taxed. This amount is not taxed. Please remember. Those who have taken home loan, remember please, those who have taken home loan. Okay, so you will deduct that interest paid from the taxable income. Ask your parents, they will tell you. If you don't know. So what remains once we deduct interest, okay, from EBIT, what we remain is earnings before taxes. So 20 minus 7.5 is equal to 12.5 million rupees. 25 minus 7.5 is equal to 17.5 million rupees earnings before taxes for year 2. Same way, 28.75 minus 7.5 is equal to 21.25 million rupees. 31.56 minus 7.5 is equal to 24.06 million rupees. 33.67 minus 7.5 is equal to 26.17 million rupees are the earnings before taxes each year. Now, you calculate the amount of tax. Tax rate is 30%. See, this is the earnings before taxes. This is the taxable income. 30% of this you have to find out. So 30% of 12.5 is 3.75. 30% of 17.5 is 5.25 million rupees. 30% of 21.25 is 6.375 million rupees. 30% of 24.06 is 7.218 million rupees. 30% of 26.17 is 7.851 million rupees. These are the amount of taxes for each year. Deduct this tax. 12.5 minus 3.75 is equal to 8.75 million rupees are earnings after taxes for year 1. So for year 2, 17.5 minus 5.25 is equal to 12.25, the earnings after taxes for year 2. 21.25 minus 6.375 is equal to 14.875. Okay, are the earnings after taxes for year 3. 24.06 minus 7.218 is equal to 16.842 is the earnings after taxes for year 4. 26.17 minus 7.851 is equal to 18.319 million rupees are the earnings after taxes for year 5. Only it is lengthier one, and remember, okay, if you don't have a calculator, you will have a lot of confusion. And calculators are allowed in the examination, IA test as well as semester end examination. Now, okay, so those students who scored like up to 90, 95, okay, so they have made this mistake in previous examinations. They forgot to deduct preference dividend. Remember this. Why they are called as preference shares? Preference shareholders have a preference over equity shareholders when it comes to payment of dividend. So after paying the dividend to preference shareholders, only from the remaining amount, if remains, equity shareholders will get the dividend. Remember this. Okay, so non-commerce students, please remember. Okay, preference shares are called as preference shares because preference shareholders have preference over equity shareholders when it comes to receiving dividend. The dividend is paid to preference shareholders first, and from the remaining amount, equity shareholders are paid the dividend. Okay, so from earnings after taxes, we deduct preference dividend 15%. So 5 million rupees, okay, was raised from by way of preference shares. 5 million rupees was raised by way of preference shares or preference capital. Okay, so simply you calculate 15% of 5 million rupees. It is 0.75. Each year you have to deduct or pay 0.75 million rupees as a dividend to preference shareholders, or it is also called a preference dividend. Many students have missed this. Okay, please remember this. Don't forget. Then simply you deduct 8.75 minus 0.75. The balance is 8. Okay. Same way, the balance here in year 2 is 11.5. The balance here in year 3 is 14.125 million rupees. The balance in year 4 is 16.092 million rupees. The balance in year 5 is 17.569 million rupees. Students, can you hear me? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Because there is a power cut here. I don't know if I'm not audible or if the screen is not visible. Okay, you just can call me. Somebody can call me. CR can better call
Good,
me.
sir.
HR or Purna. Huh? And then I'll continue because
Yes,
nothing,
sir.
Hardly some part is remaining. So to this balance, okay, we need to add back depreciation because depreciation is non-cash cost. We deducted it only for the purpose of calculating taxable income since depreciation is not taxed. So we add back depreciation. It is written add depreciation. Okay, same amount. Okay, from here. Yeah. So these all amounts. Okay, you have to put here again. So add then. Okay, then one more mistake what many students have made is they forgot about the salvage value. So the salvage value of the plant and machinery in the terminal year is 30 million rupees. Okay, 30 million rupees. Okay, you need to add it back. Then add recovery of working capital in the terminal year at its book value. It is mentioned. Salvage value and working capital are recovered at its book value. Means whatever amount is mentioned in the problem, that's it. You need not find out the present value of this in this case. That's why I said you need to read the sum carefully. Okay, book value means whatever amount is written or given in the problem. That's it. So add salvage value in the fifth year, 30 million rupees. Add a recovery of working capital. Additional working capital required was 20 million rupees. You should not forget. Add it back at its book value. You need not find out the present value of these things. Then, okay, so whatever remains, okay, from here, okay, is the CFAT, cash flow after taxes. I'm sorry, I think it is, yeah. From here. So all these you need to add now, calculate, that's it. So here 8 plus 20 is equal to 28 million rupees cash flows after taxes in year 1. 11.5 plus 15, 26.5 million rupees cash flows after taxes in year 2. 14.125 plus 11.25 is equal to 25.375 million rupees cash flows after taxes in year 3. 16.092 plus 8.44 is equal to 24.532 million rupees are the cash flows after taxes in year 4. And here, pay attention, 17.569 plus depreciation 6.33 million rupees plus salvage value 30 million rupees plus recovery of working capital 20 million rupees. Okay, at a book value, totally 73.899 million rupee is the cash flows after taxes in year 5. Just you need to estimate the cash flows after taxes. Okay, no decision is required to be made here. Okay, so if you have any questions, you can ask in the beginning of next class, or you can call me during your free time. Okay, but don't stay with confusion in the mind. Of course, the method of asking your friends is good. Talk to them, clarify your doubts. If still they are also unable to understand, call me or ask in the beginning of next class. Okay, that is the first thing. Second thing, today, yesterday I was unable to share the resources. There was an internet problem. Today I will share all the resources. Okay. And from tomorrow, we're going to make a beginning to unit 3, cost of capital. So I'll share all the related resources. A lot of resources are shared today. Please check my Google Classroom. Okay. So after which, okay, so this is the end of unit 2. And I'll also share practice problems for unit 2. You need to solve them in your homework notebook. Okay. Any doubts, you can call me or you can ask me. You can spend a couple of minutes, not a problem. It's exactly 11 now. It's not even siren has not yet happened. Any doubts? Any questions?
No, sir.
Today, okay. Pooja Jian's birthday. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, so then without spending much time, please remember, I'm sending the practice problems. You have to solve them in homework notebook. After 3 days, I will share the solutions. You have to compare. If there is any mistake, you have to correct it in your homework notebook. Homework notebook and fair notebook both will be considered. Maybe I'm saying maybe considered as CTA1 and CTA2. and those lazy students, if you have not maintained it, this is the time, huh? Okay, please remember. Don't tell me, sir, you did not give me time. Yes,
there sir. Can we write both in one book?
No, absolutely no. Clear? No. Is it clear?
Okay, sir.
For a homework notebook or a practice problems, 100 pages king size, and for fair notebook, 200 pages king size. Both ruled. Okay. I think the message is very clear. Okay, so now quickly let us celebrate birthday of Pooja GN. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, yeah. Can you
yes, sir.
On your video? She is present in the class. Yeah, she is there.
Yes, sir. Network issues.
No problem. Okay. So students, are you ready? This time at least now it's the third or fourth time. You should sing in chorus. Okay. Don't be shy.
Yes, sir.
And
yes, sir.
Many students don't bother. Huh? You don't even unmute your audio. Don't do that. Okay. Quickly, first unmute yourself so that you can sing. Do it fast. Students in screen two. Very few have unmuted. Okay. Huh? Please on my phone, I'll say 1, 2, 3, start. Okay. Those who know that there is a lot of disturbance from your end, you can mute yourself. Those who there is a disturbance from your end, only those students can mute. Okay, so ready? 1, 2, 3, start.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Okay, good one. Okay, thank you everyone.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, thank you so much, sir. Thank you all.
Pooja, celebrate your birthday, of course, but remember to live every day. Okay, every day is yours. Don't forget about every day. Okay.
Sir, thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So it was nice. Okay, gesture from the class. Thank you, everyone. Okay, I will mark your attendance. Don't worry. Okay, you can log out. Not a problem.